So,
looking at number one, we'll just turn this into one fraction. We'll add 7 plus 3, we get 10 over 4. Now, it's always important to reduce fractions, so 10 and 4 are both even numbers. They both divide by 2. So actually, before I box this, I'll do that. I'll do 5 over 2x as the final answer. Number 2, I got 1 denominator, and I have 2x minus 5. You can't actually do 2x minus 5 because 5 doesn't have an x. You can't reduce it, so that one's done. That one's done. Number 3, 21x, and I'll add 5 plus 2 to get 7. Now this one reduces. The top divides by 7, the bottom divides by 7. So that would be 1 over 3x. Really unusual up until this point of the year to have an x and a denominator, but that's what we're doing. Rational equations have x and denominators. Questions on 1 through 3. Alright, so yeah, for anybody who's on page 703. There's a bit of a rough selection, but keep it short in the assignment to just 1 through 6. It was supposed to be 1 through 14, so we're going to do 7 through 14 right now. So let's go ahead and start it up for you. Say, everybody, rush out of something. Yeah. Every day. What was that?
These both divide by 4, leaving 5 over x. Number 2, subtract. So pay attention in the middle. This would be 9 minus 4, which is 5. Done. Here, 9 minus 2x. Can't combine them. They don't both have x's. Can't reduce it. Done. Oh, you did it. Here we go. This one, 3x squared plus 6x. X squared and 6x cannot be combined. Done. Now this one, 5 and 6 are the most important.
5 and 6 are the most important. When I add across the top of 5, I get 5x plus 15. But 5x plus 15 has the greatest common factor. So I'm going to
look at it in a different way. I'm going to pull the 5 out, make it x plus 3. 5x plus 15 looks like that. There's an x plus 3 on the bottom. So this can be reduced. Now, I don't like it when they're not both in parentheses, but there could be parentheses down here. I mean, it wouldn't change anything. It's kind of like 1 times x plus 3 down there, you know? So I can reduce the x plus 3s because they're both in the top and bottom. And so the answer to 5 is actually just 5. Coincidence.
And then number 6 is a really important one. So if you skip 6 or you didn't finish it, make sure you finish it. We're going to go across the top. 4x squared minus 1. And 4x minus 1 can actually be factored. This is a little bit difficult to recognize. But 4 square roots, and so does 1. 1 is also a perfect square. So to factor square roots, I need 2 parentheses. The square root of 4 is 2, so I have 2x. The square root of 1 is 1, so I have 1 and 1. If the difference of 2 perfect squares is the middle, so that means they're opposites, that cancels, so I do plus 1 minus 1. These parentheses look kind of weird. And there's a 2x minus 1 on the bottom. So now that it's in factor form, I see something that can be reduced. The 2x minus 1 can reduce. And my final answer is 2x plus 1. Maybe that's just bad. I really crossed this out. You can't see it anymore. Questions on that one? Alright, we're going to jump right into the next section. So, this was all about example 1. I really want you guys to use your books if you need help. This one's all about example 2. And this is finding the least common multiple. So, these aren't fractions, but you kind of pretend that these are denominators. What would a common denominator be? The rules we talked about on Friday. So, a least common multiple is another name for a common denominator. And when you're picking a least common multiple, you look at the numbers in front, the coefficients, and you pick a high number that both coefficients divide into. You always include every variable with its highest exponent, and you include every binomial factor. Those are the rules we talked about Thursday. So the one thing I would write next to these directions, in order to be successful here, you must factor. Extremely 3 exclamation points of the problem.
Alright, number 7 is already factored, so I have to pick what's called an LCM. Find the least common multiple. So I just go right down the list. There's a 3 out in front of both. The common separates the two terms. I see a 3 in both of them, so my LCM has a 3. Okay. This first one has an X out in front, so I also include X. So check, check, check. And then I also have to include that X minus 2 is called a binomial factor. I also include the X minus 2. Go ahead and do number 8. Try number 8. Michaela's number 7, right? Try number 8. What would you pick for your LCM?
Yeah. 14.
definitely need two. Okay. Now, must factor, it's not card if you don't factor. So this little guy, number 9, can be rewritten. That can be rewritten because it has a GCF in it. So I'm going to rewrite this as 5 parentheses x minus 2. So what I'm really comparing is 5x comma 5 parentheses x minus 2. So the least common multiple, LCM, will have a 5 in it. Check. It will have an x in it. Check. And it'll also have x minus 2 in it. So now I'll wait, unless you guys do 10. Try to slow down. Okay, so my favorite one, two, four, maybe times x minus one. So what I'm really looking at is 4x and 4 parentheses x minus 1. So the LCM will definitely have 4. Check. It'll definitely have x. Check. And it'll definitely have x minus 1. Checkity check, check. Okay, getting more complicated, aren't we? Okay. So we gotta factor the yellow. We gotta factor the blue. This time, both things factor. You have to factor it before you pick your least common multiple. So that's the challenge. We gotta take, let's say, 2 out of this first one. It becomes x squared minus 9. And then you do it again, x plus 3x minus 3. So that's 2 parentheses x plus 3x minus 3. That's the first one we read. It's 9 square roots. So square root 9 is 3. That's where we look at. In the blue bit, you're thinking, well, what will multiply to negative 12 and add to 4?
4
and
negative 3.
Positive 4. So, you can't even start making your LCM list until you can factor them up. Now that they're both written in their simplest forms, now I think, well, what would I actually include in the least common multiple? Definitely need the 2 out front. I'm definitely going to need x plus 3. I will also include the x minus 3. So, everything here
is going to go on my least common multiple. And then I start with this one. Okay, I definitely need x plus 4. I have to include every binomial factor.
Check. And then I go to this.
And I look. It's already in the list. I don't need to write that one again. Check it off. Already listed.
This is your LCM. It's a struggle because the name is least common multiple, but it's actually a really big name. But least common multiple is how I write everything from the writing to. Alright, I'll wait now so you can try 12. First, take a 4 out, then 2 roots.
Now this is the special number 9, the square root. So this factors again to x plus 3, x minus 3. And that's just something to memorize. This gets your brain. So this is it. Don't include that one. And then this one. This is when So this coupon that I had just said before, pull a 4 out, we have x squared minus 4. 4 square roots. So you can go it again. X plus 2, x minus 2, with a 4 out front. Just like the 9, where plus 3 minus 3 is 4 as opposed to minus 2. This one. But multiply is 2, 14, or 9.
7 and 2.
7 and 2. So now I'm going to make my final list. What's all the multiples listed together? There's a 4, check. X plus 2, check. X minus 2, check. X plus 7, check. X plus 2, are there. Not how'd you do? Can you get 12 right?
So,
other people. Alright, 13 and 14 are actually easier than 11 and 12. A little bit easier. 11 and 12 are the most of the wrong ones. Who already has 11 and 12 to do 13? Multiply is 14 and add 8. So that's where you come up with 7 and 2.
Other questions going on your thought? Alexis, did you finish 13 questions?
I didn't
know what that
was.
13? Well, multiply to negative 40 and add to 8.
What about doing it? 8 negative 5.
Negative 48 times negative 5. 8 minus 5 is 3. That's how you compare it up. X plus 8. X minus 5. And then the other one, you don't have to factor that. That makes 13 a little bit easier.
Is the second one, you don't factor. It's just X minus 8. You can't do anything with it. So
now if I have to make a list of common multiples, that means I can just list everything I see. So it's X plus 8, X minus 5, check, check. And then there's also a minus 8, check. List them all. The sign is in there and list it. No, wait, unless you guys finish 14. What multiplies the negatives? Don't call it out. What multiplies the negatives? 63 and adds the negative 2. Think about it for a minute.
No,
no, no. All right. Well, that's the 960 there. 9 times 7. So we have the your common denominator will be the LCM. So your step one is to pick an LCM. LCM as a common denominator. Step two. Multiply any missing factors to the top and bottom. Step three, add or subtract. Okay, so we got to make a common denominator. You take whatever the LCM Because those answers are in the back of the book.
Yeah,
you do 17. Sure. Now I do 16 first, and then I'll do 17, and then I'll do 18. Okay. Yeah, look at all that. That's a long problem.
Sure, I think I've got it. I'm still going to try.
Good. And then if you want to, like, take a moment while I'm doing 16, you can look at these two examples and see if that helps at all. Okay. All right. So what would my LCM be when I look at 3x and 4x? Well, actually, I'm not going to look at it all together. I'll just look at them 3 and 4. A high number that can be divided by both 3 and 4 is 12. 3 goes into 12, so that is 4. I also have to include x in the LCM. So the LCM is 12x, a high number, and it includes every variable. So what I will do is I will write two brand new fractions with the common denominator. 12x, 12x. That's step one. You pick an LCM with a common denominator. Step two, multiply any missing factors to the top and bottom. Okay, well, when I look at 3, the original denominator, it's supposed to be a 12. I want it to be 12, so it's common. So I would have to multiply that by 4. So if I multiply the bottom by 4, also multiply the top by 4, given a 32. Okay. Now, on the second one, how do you turn 4 into 12? Well, that one you would multiply by 3, so you also multiply the top by 3, giving a 15. That's step 2. Step 3, you add or subtract. So now I can actually do 32 plus 15, and I have 47 over 12. And that's best case scenario. You want to start with the more basic ones to lead up into the ones that you can really get lost in. Questions on 16. Where did this come from? Why did you take that? Alright, we're going to go over to 17 next. I'll give an hour next. Okay, now an LCM has to include every factor. Now, these things don't have parentheses around them, but they are unique. They are different. So my LCM would be both x plus 4 and x plus 6. We list them both. There's my first fraction, and here's my second one. A doctor is mix them in. I keep them separate. They're both there. Write it out twice. Just like I wrote this all back out twice, right? Alright, now I'm going to step 2 and multiply any messy factors to the top and bottom. Now 17, the first fraction didn't originally have x plus 6, so since I'm multiplying it in, I'm also to multiply it to the top. I put the x plus 6 to the top and bottom. Now I have to distribute here. Distribute that. Now on the second one, I have to multiply in the x plus 4, top and bottom, and I distribute. Show 1 there. So that just gives. Alright, now this one is subtraction. So I'm going to go across the top. I'm just going to add a subtraction. I'm just going to really rewrite this as one big fraction. It would be 3x plus 18 minus x plus 4 all over 1 denominator. No, now since I'm subtraction, I'm actually going to make sure I distribute the minus sign. I'm writing a lot. When I do it myself, by myself, I distribute the minus sign and I rewrite it already distributed here. But I want to make it very clear that this minus sign has to get distributed to that second number.
So it's 3x plus 18 divided by minus 4. And then I'll combine the terms. 3x minus x is 2x. 18 minus 4 is 14.
It should be the 2, it would be 2x plus 14. We had you. Yeah. Is it wrong? I don't mean, is it wrong if I put on, I put it 2 on the outside of parentheses, and I put x. X plus 7, yeah.
And that gets distributed. So that's 2x squared minus 6x. This one's a little bit better because there's a plus sign in the middle. It just came out of like terms, so that's confusing. So if I add across the top, 2x squared. For the helpers, I can combine 9x minus 6x and make it 3x, and then plus 9 at the end. Louis, you got it right? Louis, say you're right, please. Did you hear it? Number 20. This will be my last one. And then you guys are doing you're doing, you know, 15 through 22 odds, and I'll leave with you, but you guys finished the odds I didn't get to. We got, I mean, we have, is it 6 minutes left? So I can factor 20. What multiplies to negative 14 and adds to 5?
It's positive 7.
Positive 7 and a negative 2.
Oh.
So my common denominator, my LCM, will have x plus 7 in it, check. X minus 2 in it, check. And the x plus 7 is already listed. So that's my LCM. It has these two sets of parentheses. So I write that twice. I'm making a common denominator. I have to change them both. Okay, now, the first one, I'm really not changing. X plus 2, X minus 2, we're already back in there. So I just think about X squared minus 7, no change. No change. The second one didn't have X minus 2 anymore. Now, up top is X plus 3, X minus 2. That has to be a full double distribution in FOIL, first, outer, and we got to do x times negative 2, 3 times x, 3 times negative 2. X, we're here, minus 2x, plus 3x, minus 6. On top of it, it's a subtraction problem. Okay, here's how it is. I'm gonna write it out to you guys. So it's x squared minus 5 minus sign. And then I'm gonna put the second one in parentheses so I remember to distribute the minus sign. I only do this with subtraction. First, I can add 5. Negative 2 times 3 is 1. Alright, so in subtraction, so we have to distribute this minus sign to the whole right polynomial. We're almost done. And then I will combine the terms. Oh my god. That's minus x squared. So this is negative x.
That's not the case. Show me your work for 19. What did you get?
Negative x plus 1.
you said is right. I want to see what you did. You didn't know.
Thank you.